Sometimes I think I've covered almost every single Witcher that we know of. When suddenly, while looking through the Book of Tales, which is considered CDPR canon, I came across a Witcher I'd never heard of before. Bardas of Khoroth. Bardas of Khoroth is a Witcher from the School of the Cat. Parts of his origins are given away by his name, as Khoroth does indeed refer to the Khoroth Desert. As an infant, he and his parents found their way into the desert for some unknown reason. The family would have met their end in the desert's heat, as they had no water left to drink. Which was when family came across the Dinmar caravan of the Cat School. Bardas' parents traded their son to the Cat Witchers in exchange for a drink of water, which would be the only memory of them that stayed with him. The young boy spent his entire youth with the caravan as he grew up, and eventually he underwent the Trial of the Grasses. Unfortunately, he died during the trial. Of course he didn't die, otherwise he wouldn't be a Witcher and I would not have made this video. But the mutation was not fully successful. Bardas was enhanced, but not quite as much as the other Witchers. It would be something he would strive to fix later on, but for now, he was still an excellent killer. When Bardas was still a young Witcher, a new type of contract started to become more common for the Cat Witchers. Contracts on the heads of humans. From this, we can conclude that Parvus joins relatively soon after the Gaspas of Leda started the caravan. Bardas would combine killing humans with killing monsters over the years, and he seemed to really like what he was doing. Shortly after Bardas set out on his own, away from the caravan, he would specialize in killing humans, roaming from city to city in the northern realms where he would find plenty of work. And whilst Bardas was very proficient at his job, he still felt that he was lacking in his mutations. He wanted to fix his infections, which drove him into using Katagan mutagens, which he believed would finally fix the things that were wrong with him. With this supposed fix came, however, a slight side effect. Bardas' arms became slightly longer, making him a bit more inhuman in the eyes of others. But, as he would say, when you need someone dead, it makes sense to hire a monster. As Bardas appears in a tabletop role-playing game, there are choices which lead to his appearance and ultimate fate. The story he appears in takes place in Catwin, near the Alderwood, around the time of The Witcher 3's witch hunts. In the Alderwood lives a Sylvan with a magical wand who can control the nearby woods. The Sylvan, who is named Oberhassel, sees himself as a playwright, and a number of adolescents from nearby villages have willingly joined him as thespians for his plays. The players have to convince three villages that the Sylvan is not a danger, and that the adolescents who are seen missing were actually in the woods on their own free will. After deals start to be made, and there's only one village left, the remaining village hires Bardas to slay Oberhassel, a dangerous job for which they are willing to pay him 1,500 crowns. Bardas, being a Cat Witcher, had no issue with morally questionable contracts, nor does he have any issue with abandoning them if he's adequately compensated. In his case, he'll leave for 3,000 crowns. Although a good haggler might cut a few crowns off that. Depending on the choices, the Witcher could leave you after he takes the bribe, but if the players would rather fight him, they have to deal with a dangerous Witcher. His only goal is to kill Oberhassel. He will attack anyone who gets in his way, but the Sylvan's death is the only one he's getting paid for. If the Witcher sees he's becoming too weak in battle, he will retreat, heal himself, and return a short time later for a second chance. A third chance he won't take, however, as he's not willing to die for this contract. It is, however, possible to kill Bardas, which means he has a no definitive fate. It all depends on the player's choices. Bardas will most likely never appear in a future Witcher game, because created only for the TRPG story. The way Bardas looks, his appearance, is kind of interesting. He almost looks more like a bear Witcher, with his beard and bald head. His armor looks like a combination between a bear and Cat School armor, due to the lack of sleeves, which resembles the Cat School, and at the same time the longer bear school armor ropes with some fur or hair attached to where the sleeves should be. But what do you think of Bardas? What fate would you choose for him and why? And whilst he most likely will never appear in a future game, would you like to see his armor make an appearance? Till the next video. Bye.